According to Peter Wamboka, the Director of Communication at the Science Foundation for Livelihoods and Development, the ban on charcoal use is not feasible as long as alternatives are not provided. He says Uganda possesses sources of energy, including nuclear power, but these assets have languished, largely underutilized and non-functional. He advocates for increased investment in clean energy sources such as solar.
You know, oil is nearby, but why people who are exploring for oil, whenever they came across gas, they just closed the gas findings. Yet natural gas is very, very important in this mix we are talking about, which Patricia just made reference to. And that gas would be, you know, distributed in rural areas through the rural electrification project, but was closed. Gas has not been developed. Rural electrification was closed. So rural people would have access all these energies we are talking about, but the project that would have brought this close to them was closed.
A report by the United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization highlights that deforestation in sub-Saharan Africa is primarily driven by the widespread use of fuel, despite accounting for roughly a sixth of the world's...
Greenpeace sued the EU because the EU had included nuclear in its energy policy, because they claim that nuclear is not carbon-free. And we took a letter to them and we told them that as Replanet Africa, we demand that they stop opposing nuclear energy, because the evidence and the science shows that nuclear energy is a clean energy source. It does not give off carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases. The science is there.
Remaining forests, Africa contributes a staggering 43% of global deforestation. Solar energy in Uganda remains underutilized beyond lighting, while wind energy potential varies across the country, with the Karamoja region showing promise for small-scale electricity generation and special applications like water pumping.